There has been a lot of controversy around genetically modified food. The supporters of GM technology say that it increases the yield, reduces the input cost, and protects the environment. Moreover, it is their claim that the food derived from GM technology is substantially equivalent to the conventional way of agriculture. But the opponent do not agree. With me today to discuss the issue is Dr. Devinder Sharma, who is a renowned food policy analyst and also the coordinator of Coalition for GM-Free India. Dr. Sharma, thank you very much for joining us. Dr. Sharma, I'd like to ask you the first question. Why are you so much against the GM technology and GM food?
Because this is an unnatural food. It is basically a contamination of the food. And also, it contains tremendous risks which the human population is refusing to accept and acknowledge. Now, nature has given us abundance of food supplies. There is no dearth of food on the earth. Why are we contaminating food? Why are we making food a complex subject? Whereas food is simple, it's a romance, and it is something that we all cherish. You will see that food that we have today, or the food that we all talk about today, is going to undergo tremendous change. The food that we will all be eating 10 years from now, if the genetic engineering has its way, will not be the same that what you and me are eating today.
Your fear is that we are heading for something unknown.
Well, it is like, you know, going into the black hole. And how dangerous it can be, I think, is something which I would be willing to take that risk only if there is a kind of a disaster awaiting or there is a desperation. Now, the tragedy is that we don't have desperation, neither there is a disaster waiting. Then why are we playing with the food? When you play with food, you know, one, you've done damage to your environment, you've done damage to your human health. The third and foremost is you are also playing with your genetic makeup, because what the food will do into your body is something still unknown.
Dr. Sharma, the supporters of the GM technology, they say that all the claims about the harmful effects of the GM food are exaggerated, because people in the US have been eating it for over a decade and a half. They are not dying over there. So why there is so much hue and cry in our country?
Well, US is not a kind of a role model for the world, first of all. If US is a role model for us, you will be surprised that the pornography industry of America is 35 times the size of Hollywood. Should the world have it? You will be surprised that 40% Americans do not know whether the sun revolves around the earth or earth revolves around the sun. Is that the model the world should follow? What I'm trying to say is that just to say that in US this is happening, but let me also tell you, those who say that US people are not dying, never tell us that 4 lakh people are dying every year from eating junk food. We are never told. The kind of pressures that we have to expand the market for junk food is enormous in India. But did you ever hear anybody saying that this has proven killer in America? So we try to, you know, look at what is of interest to us, and then we project that kind of imagination or that kind of a picture. And that would result in human losses, and we are not worried about, because it's taken as a collateral damage. To your question, that if Americans can be eating it, why are we worried? Well, if that is the situation, I think if Americans today, if cigarette smoking is number 2 killer in America, food is number 1 killer in America, if that's the model we want to bring into India, I have no objection. If the nation accepts that, fine. If they want to die, they should die. But the fact of the matter is, that is not the model that we have to follow. India can be a healthy nation without importing or without contaminating your food supplies with genetically modified foods. You will be surprised, there's only one human clinical trial in the world till today. Even in that human clinical trial, it has been found that it is damaging to the people who consume genetically modified food. Why is the industry or the governments refraining from conducting tests to tell us how harmful it can be? Why is it so? That means clearly they want to suppress that information. So you are selling a bad product by just suppressing its ill effects that we all should know.
The biotechnology company often says that the food that they are bringing in the market has been approved by Food and Drug Administration of the US. So if that be the case, then what is your problem?
See, the United States FDA is one of the regulatory authorities. US FDA, in my understanding, is one of the corrupt bodies that US has. First, the evidence that, you know, one gentleman in America took the US FDA to court. 44,000 pages which questioned the harmful impacts or the relevance of GM food for human health tumbled out of the cupboards there. And the US FDA didn't have anything to answer those things. In fact, it has been established very well that the scientists within the US FDA had actually posed questions which the bureaucrats turned it down. Now, if this can happen in one of the most distinguished regulatory authorities, you know what can happen in India with Genetic Engineering Approval Committee.
Is there a ground to oppose the GM food on ethical basis?
I think, look at the way the genes are being now tinkering, or the food is now being tinkered with. You know, pigs, the gene from pigs have been taken out and put into cauliflower. The gene from pigs are being taken to put into rice. And, you know, rice genes have gone into animals. And the human genes, the gene for milk in human beings, human females, has been now inserted into rice. And the scientists are trying to say this will take care of diarrhea in human beings. Now, all these permutation combinations have actually gone beyond the ethics that the society has been living in. And I think that is, again, going to create, whether it's a religious issue or whether it is going to be an ethical issue or a morality issue, that I think is also going to be infringed by genetically modified foods, and no questions are being asked. The laboratories are trying to come out with these products without even addressing these issues or letting this society debate whether this food is required for them or not required for them. Let the communities decide whether they would like to have a pig gene into cauliflower or a pig gene into rice, and why should they prefer a gene, a kind of a rice or a cauliflower, with a gene of pig for that matter.
Dr. Sharma, how serious is the problem of genetic pollution, and is it some kind of an irreversible process?
The entire effort of the industry is to contaminate the world with genetic engineered products. The first and foremost is happening in agriculture. Now it is being said, you know, the way the plants are being released in India or in other countries, you know, the point is it is going beyond the control of the human society. So now it is being said, okay, now we have done the damage. So it's already contaminated, so why stop it now? So that is the kind of impression, or that is the kind of aim, or that, let's say, the industry has to see that everything is got contaminated, so then there can be no questions mark on the contamination. Now, to me, this is a very serious issue, because plants have a uniqueness. Once you contaminate those plants, you are actually bringing in genetic pollution. Once you bring that genetic pollution, it can't be reverted back. Because what has gone, see, for instance, when we were playing with chemicals, when you take your car out of your garage, the moment you put your a pedal or you next put your feet on the accelerator, the exhaust would release chemicals, molecules. Now, those molecules stay in the environment for about 100 years. It is true they add on to global warming, but the fact of the matter is those molecules don't multiply. But when you genetically pollute, you have released a gene into the atmosphere. That gene is a living organism. It can multiply. So earlier, the molecule was there in the environment. It was contaminating the environment, polluting the environment, what is called as chemical pollution. But it was not multiplying. Today, the gene is going to multiply. So it's the biological pollution that the world will have will be much more potent, obviously, than what the chemical pollution was.
Well, the European countries in the beginning were really very much supportive of the technology, and they have just simply, you know, let their door open and just welcomed it as some kind of a revolutionary technology. But what happened actually? Why the European countries have banned and they have become so vociferous in their opposition to GM technology?
Well, I think we need to know there is something called a shock and awe. In Europe, what happened was they were faced first with mad cow disease, and then they were faced with foot and mouth disease. Now, in both these diseases had inflicted a massive, massive destruction of the cattle. And they had to burn cattle. Thousands and thousands of cattle were burnt alive. Now, in that particular situation, they have seen the horror of all these kinds of food and feeds. Now, they realize if it can happen to animals, it can happen to human beings also. So, therefore, there is a kind of that shock is reverberating in their mind, and that is why they have objected to the entry of genetically modified food. In India, we still have to look forward to that kind of a shock and awe so that people can become alert to. Indians are no better than any other population in this world. We also await people to die, then only we wake up to the threats that people have been telling. I think that is where our problem arises.
But there have been a lot of claims to be made about that the GM foods are harmful for animals, and the test actually which they have conducted in the lab. But is there any evidence to suggest that GM food is really harmful to human health?
There are ample evidence which show that BT cotton is not only harmful for the animals, but also harmful for the human beings. Now, it's very interesting. The scientists, of course, will not accept it. But if you look at what has happened in Andhra Pradesh, there was reports of hundreds of sheep and goat dying from eating the leaves of BT cotton. Then there are reports from Punjab now which say hundreds of sheep have died and goats have died because of eating of contaminated or let's say BT cotton leaves. In Haryana, we have evidence that, you know, buffalo have died from eating.